The other thing that we are going to see is the investment theory. You remember that we started with the consumption theory. The second one is saving theory. The third one is investment theory. Investment is defined as the expenditure on capital good with an aim of increasing production. Capital good, these are the goods that can be used in the production of other goods and services. If you buy that capital good, you make or you do what we call an investment. There are two main classes of investment: fixed income investment, variable income investment. Every person can invest in a given business, but there are some factors which can influence the level of investment in an economy from either one person to another or from one country to another. The first one, there is income of an individual or a firm. Level of saving. Economic environment, government policy, rate of interest, consumer demand for goods and services, political situation, level of entrepreneurship, general price level, etc. Meaning that also we can add the level of education. There are different factors which can influence one to save. If you know the importance of saving and you manage the risk involved in saving for a given business, you can be influenced by one factors among others. The limitation of investment in Rwanda. Why all Rwandans cannot invest? There are some factors or limitation which can hinder someone to invest capital in Rwanda. Among the others, there are a limited market. If there is not enough market, investment also is reduced. Underdeveloped infrastructure. If in a given area there is no electricity, water, good roads, and so on, at that time investment rate reduces. Unfavorable investment climate, limited capital. If there are more number of poor people, the investment rate reduced and vice versa. Political instability or insecurity in a given area also can limit the rate of investment. Higher population growth rate. Higher level of liquidity preference. If the people prefer to keep money in liquidity form, the rate of investment reduces and vice versa. Limited entrepreneurial skills. When the people do not know how they can invest, they can create their own business or innovate what other have been created, the rate of investment reduced. Competition from outside countries. If the outside countries have high rate of competition compared to your home country, the rate of investment reduced. Ways of improving investment in Rwanda. What you can do in order to improve the rate of investment in Rwanda. Some among the others are the following: expanding the market, opening new market, searching the market in other countries, making economic integration, and so on, developing more feeder road, favorable investment climate, improving entrepreneurial skills, controlling the rate of population growth, and so on. If you make in place the following, it can allow every person to investe et des capitaux. Multiplier is a subtopic of the above things. Multiplier refers to the number of times initial or the original change in expenditure multiplies itself to give a final change in income. The multiplier can be shown as flow. The meaning of multiplier, how you can spend the money depending on how income change. If income change by increasing, how your spending change also. It will take you how long time to change what you spend if the income change is the meaning of multipliers. Multiplier is expressed with M equals to change in income over change in expenditure. You remember that change? You take the current income that you receive as net income minus the past net income that you received. Change in expenditure, you compare what you spend in this moment compared to what you spend in the past. Here there is an example. Given that the change in expenditure equals to 50,000 and the change in income equals to 100,000, calculate the multiplier. Multiplier also can be expressed as Q. Change in income over change in expenditure is calculated well. The final answer is 2. The size of a multiplier is determined by the proportion of extra income going on extra consumption. For example, before you receive 20,000 as income, you spend 15,000 for consuming goods and services. If income change and you receive 30,000, how much money you will spend, you will add for consuming extra good or services is the meaning of multiplier. The higher the marginal purpose to consume, the higher the multiplier and vice versa. If the consumption increase, it push the multiplier to increase and vice versa. Multiplier also can be calculated by taking 1 over 1 minus marginal propensity to consume, or multiplier can be calculated by 1 over marginal propensity to save. You remember the formula of marginal propensity to consume and marginal propensity to save. You have seen them above. At this time, is that time in the exercise there is no change in income or change in expenditure, or only you have a marginal propensity to save or marginal propensity to consume. Thanks very much for your attention again.